So third method you are seeing here, the name is called a tandem art. The tandem art is a paracorporeal centrifugal flow pump that withdraws blood from the left atrium via transseptal catheter and returns the blood to the leiomyomatal system. So again you are seeing that the coronary assist device in human heart, it is a peripheral cannulation via internal jugular vein and axillary artery in a left hand side diagram. Right hand side diagram is a possible ambulation with the internal jugular and axillary artery cannulation. So it's a highly difficult treatment. It is having a provides a lot of pain, another one blood loss, another one a swelling of in the muscles, and these are all, I mean these one, the person who had a severe heart attack, immediately they will go for this method. So here they are placing that aortic balloon pump in intra, that is intra means internally, internally near the aortic vessels. So here the intra aortic balloon pump, that is IABP as shown in figure, are commonly used to assist in varying patients from a cardiopulmonary bypass or when patients experience cardiogenic shock secondary to an acute myocardial infarction. Initial success in human implanted IABP occurred in 1968. The IABP is inserted through the femoral or axillary artery and placed within the descending aorta. The patient's electrocardiogram, that is ECG, supports the negative or a polythene balloon inflates with gas. Here the gas is a helium gas. It's a, we can call it as helium gas, is a noble gas. It cannot react with any kind of a chemical composition. So it won't harm to the human body. That's why they have selected, and also that the helium, its atomic mass is a very less one, and also it will obey the pumping action, that is inflation and deflation of helium gas is very easiest, and it can go through the balloon pump, that is called balloon tube. It can easily move through the balloon tube, and it provides pressure on coronary arteries and aorta. By that way it will repair the damaged tube, blood tube, and it will make the blood flow go in a proper manner into the heart. So by that way they will be getting a normal heart functioning. Here the helium is a gas given via per-transitious tube during the systole and deflates during the systole. That is, per-transitious tube is during diastole. It will be inflate, and during the systole it will be deflates. this counter pulsation to perform reduce the amount of work that heart has performed by supplying cardiac output by approximately 50% of work. The complications associated with the IABP are predominantly due to the vascular injury that occurs during the insertion into the aorta. Additional complication includes excessive bleeding and limb ischemia. The IABP has been used for temporary support. That means treatment period is means of 53 hours for a short term. Ventricular assistance and bridge to transplantation up to 70 days. The IABP is currently being adapted for permanent ventricular assistance. The IABP has been used successfully in a cardiac shock and the ventricle to regulate flow directions. Air pulses tank are generated by the external drive unit are used to compress the flexible blood sac periodically. An automatic control system varies the cardiac output by adjusting the heart rate and the time for ventricular filling in response to an increase in filling pressure. The pump is placed extracorporeal on the patient's abdomen. The inlet cannula is inserted into the apex of the left ventricle and connected to the inlet port of the ventricular assist device. The outflow cannula is attached between the outflow port of the ventricular assist device and the assenting aorta. As an end-to-side and astomosis, that is called astomosis, in that the both inflow and outflow cannula passes through the skin below the rib cage. The first human implant of this type of assist device occurred in 1976. The bend stays are implanted in over 1,700 patients worldwide. The pneumatic pumps can also be used to assist the right ventricle by itself or simultaneously with an additional pump that assists the left ventricle. The other types of pneumatic devices are available in the market. The name is called Biomet. The manufacturer is Danvers MA. Another one is BVS. That is name is called Biventricular System 5000. And third one is LVAS, Left Ventricular Assist Device. So these are all different name of the IABP device which is available in the market. The Biomet BVS 5000 is an external dual chamber device that can provide support to one or both ventricles. The chambers utilize polyethylene walls to regulate the blood flow direction. More than 3000 implants have been performed worldwide by Biomet BVS 5000. Thank you very much. And you have learned many things about a cardiac assist device. First you have learned a ECPT, that is external counter pulsation technique that has been given outside the device. That is called they are fitting the device on the outside the patients. That is outpatient can they can avail that treatment. This one is that is called IABP, that is intra-aortic balloon pump treatment have been used when the person is having a severe heart attack or a cardiac shock. They have to go for this IABP method. In IABP method, they have two components. One is a balloon tube, another one is a pump. So here the balloon tube and pump, they have connected at a coronary artery and aortic vessels. In this case, when heart is failed to pump the blood in a proper manner, so these one, the IABP method, it will remove all the blocks in the blood tube in a coronary and aorta. By that way, there is a rich oxygenated blood is can be supplied to the heart, human heart. So then the heart function will be normal. So this has been taken 52 hours treatment, and it is having a lot of complication. So these can be used severe heart attack. They had a severe heart attack. They are providing these types of treatment. Thank you for listening class. I hope that it help you a lot. You can remember this one, and also you can while you are working as a biomedical engineer, this kind of knowledge provide a lot of information. Thank you. We'll see it in a next class.